What are the highest paid programming languages on the market? I will tell you in this video. So I scraped thousands of job postings to answer the question, which programming languages are in demand right now? Hello everyone, welcome back. If you are going to put aside the time and energy to learn or to advance a programming language, you would want to choose the ones where there are jobs. To get to the heart of this matter, I scraped and analyzed thousands of job details from Indeed.com. I extracted the information of job title, company name, location, salary range if posted, and the full job description. For this exercise, I focused on four job titles: software developers, software engineer, data scientist, and machine learning engineer. And these titles fall into two big categories. Software developer, which total 1,722 jobs, versus data scientist, which total 2,052 jobs. Among all these 3,800 job postings, 45% offer the option of remote work, and 20% listed out the expected salary ranges. Let's see which programming languages are most in demand for software developers or engineers. And before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below. I'll be really appreciated. Here, these two, we have Kotlin and Swift, coming out at 2%. Which means that 2% of all software developers' jobs I script requires either one of them. So we know that Kotlin is mainly used for Android apps and Swift for Apple apps. So 2%-ish actually indicates that mobile applications are relatively smaller than other programming languages on the job market. Moving up this chart, we have C# and C++, which are fairly close at about 18%. Almost 1 in 5 software developer jobs require C# or C++. Then higher than C# is HTML/CSS, coming in third place, sitting at 28%. And right below HTML/CSS is arguably everyone's favorite, Python. 1 in 4, which is 25% job postings for software developers, listed Python as a requirement. So Python is used for data science, machine learning, and it has gained tremendous popularity in the past few years. Now we have our top two in-demand programming languages, Java and JavaScript, coming out close at 33%. Both are general languages used in building enterprise applications, and both are equally in demand in the job market. So if you want to develop for the web, then choose JavaScript. And if you think you might like to make, say, Android applications, then Java would be a better choice, because it was the primary language used for Android applications before Kotlin was introduced. Here, I also want to point out that we have SQL, also high in demand. Even though SQL isn't a programming language per se, it's still required by most companies, mainly because the majority of data nowadays still stored in SQL compliance databases. So the same thing for Git, which is mainly used for version control. Another fun exploration I did is to find out which combinations of these languages are associated with higher salaries. And I'm happy to report that the results are pretty consistent with the language rankings we just looked at. From here, we can see that JavaScript combined with HTML/CSS tops this competition with an average salary of $133,000 a year, and followed by the combination of C# or Java with Python and SQL, which comes out at $113,000 in terms of annual average salary. This is another piece of evidence that Java or JavaScript in combination with Python, SQL, and HTML are not only most in demand, but also most highly compensated. Now, moving on from software developers' jobs, how about data scientists and machine learning engineers? What does the situation look like on the data science side? Doing the same analysis, we can see that there is some overlap between developers and data scientists in terms of technical requirements. So for example, here we have C# and JavaScript, which are required in about 3% to 5% of data scientists or machine learning engineers' job postings. Next up, we have the big old SAS, coming at 7.2%. SAS is one of the primary statistical languages before R took off in about 2010. And even now, pharmaceutical companies in the US still use SAS for FDA filing. So if you are thinking about data scientist jobs at a pharmaceutical company, learning some SAS basic may be helpful. A little higher than SAS comes Scala, sitting at 7.5%. Scala is good at working with large data sets. Many of the high-performance data science projects are built on top of the parallel computing framework Spark or Hadoop, and these data science frameworks usually are written in Scala or Java, and this may be the reason why we also saw Java ranked number 4 in this chart with 17.3%. Moving up the chart, we have R coming in 3rd place with 23%, and all of these don't even come close to the number 1 language, Python, at an incredible 71%. And this means that a large majority of companies posted on Indeed.com require Python for their data science related jobs. In fact, if you are applying for a data science job, chances are you either are going to be building models in Python or the company already has models written in Python for you to maintain. Sitting in between Python and R is SQL at 44.1%, which comes no surprise as a data scientist needs to extract data from the database using SQL. And the same as we saw for software developers, Git is also a must-have for data scientists. So clearly, if you would want to learn or to advance one programming language for a data science career, Python is likely to give you the highest marginal return. If you need more evidence, here is the salary information based on combinations of different languages. So for example, a combination of Python, SQL, and Git tops all with an average annual salary at $153,000. Now, all these findings tell us that for developers, Java or JavaScript still dominates the job market with an increasing demand for Python as well. Whereas for data scientists, Python appears to be the absolute top one language, both in the number of job postings and in the job's compensation levels. Another thing to factor in is that language popularity is just one piece of the puzzle. You still need to consider the platform-specific feature of a language. For example, no matter how much you like Python, if your potential employer is a Microsoft developer, then you would want to work with C#. So my advice is pretty simple. Get started with learning one language only. So for developers, that would be Java or JavaScript. And for data scientists, that would be Python. I do have a video talking about how to learn programming fast, and I will have it linked here if you're interested. Once you get comfortable with this language, try to venture out and learn at least one other language or framework, depending on the kind of job you want to do. So for example, if you are a developer and your job involves analytics, or you want to do a little more machine learning, then learn Python as a second language would be a great idea. I think being comfortable with multiple languages is important, because what you learned today is probably not going to be enough for your entire career. So to stay competitive in the job market, learning how to learn a language is as important as learning a language itself. And the best way to achieve this is to learn more than one. Lastly, remember to add SQL and Git in your to learn language stash, because you will need them in pretty much all technical positions. And with this, it concludes my video today. So hope you find this informative and useful. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like and subscribe. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys pretty soon in my next video. Bye guys.